Hey guys, welcome back to Learn Python the Hard Way. Today we're going to focus on exercise 25, even more practice. In this exercise, we are going to focus on working with functions and variables, and we're also going to learn about a new way on how to execute, how to run them. So as always, let's get started by actually typing out the exercise code. For that, we opened our terminal over here and navigated to our directory. From here, I'm going to create a new file and open it in Visual Studio Code, which is a text editor I'm using. For that, we can just type in code space and then the name of the Python file we want to create. So in this case, exercise25.py. So this is going to open a new file in Visual Studio Code, and we can start out by typing in the text code as a code here for that exercise. So we start out by defining a new function called breakWords, which takes an argument called stuff. And again, we're going to add 4 space characters and then type in this function will break up words for us. And we are using the triple quotation mark to enter this string in here. Next, we're going to create a variable called words and assign it stuff, which is again the parameter we define, so the argument we're taking for our function here. And here we're going to call the split function and we pass in a space character. And finally, we're going to return words. Next, let's define a second function called sort words, which takes words as an argument here. So here we type out sorts the words and we return words again, but we call sorted on it. So this is going to sort our words and then we return them back. Next, we define a function called print first word, which also takes a parameter called or an argument called words. And let's add the description here, prints the first word after popping it off. So here we define word. We take words, so the argument we pass in here, and we pop off the first zeroth entry and store that back in the variable called word. And then we're going to print that out. So instead of returning it, we're just going to print it. Next, let's define print last word as opposed to print first word, which we just defined, which also takes words as an argument. So here we're going to say prints the last word after popping it off. And it's quite similar to the previous function, except for saying words.pop and passing in a zero, we're going to pass in -1, which is basically the last entry from our words entry here. And then again, we're going to print this out. After that, let's define a new function called sort sentence, which takes sentence as a parameter here. And here we say takes in a full sentence and returns the sorted words. All right, and that's going to use break words, which is a function we defined up here. So we are using that again. And we're going to pass in sentence. All right, and now we're going to return words, the variable we defined, but before that we're going to call sort word, which is a function we defined up here, which is actually sorting the words that we pass to it. We're going to call that on our words variable and then return that back. So basically this function here, sort sentence, combines both break words function up here as well as sort words and then returns back the value. Next we have print first and last. This prints the first and last words of the sentence. And here again we're going to call break words on the sentence, just as we did on the previous in the previous function. And now we're going to call print first word and pass in words. And we're going to call print last word. And again, we pass in words again. And both print word, print first word and print last word, of course, again, are functions we defined previously. So we're now able to use them and to combine them into a new function. And finally, we have a new function called print first and last sorted. And this is going to sort the words, then print the first and last one out. So again, here we're just going to build on top of what we already defined. So we're going to call sort sentence again, pass in sentence. So the parameter we defined here. Next, we're going to call print first word and pass in words. And then we're going to call print last word and again pass words to it. And the difference to the previous function is that instead of using break words here, we're using sort sentence, so the function up here. So first of all, we're going to sort the sentence that we pass in, store that in words, and then we're going to print out the first word and the last word. All right, so we defined the various functions. Let's save this right now. And in order to make sure that we actually typed this out correctly, that we didn't make any mistakes here, in terms of indentation, for example, we can open the terminal. And let's first of all run Python 3 and then exercise 25, so the name of the script we just wrote. And we see there's no error shown, so therefore it should be correct. All right, and what's different in this exercise compared to the previous exercises is that instead of actually calling the file directly, we're going to use the Python interpreter IDLE to actually call the file, to import it, and then to execute our different functions that we defined. So to do that, let's switch to our terminal and type out Python 3 or Python 3.6, which is the version of the book that is being used here. And this is going to open our Python interpreter. Now we can see the prompt here. Let me just remove the other text, the prompt here. And now we can start out by actually typing out our commands here. So here, if we are in this Python interpreter, we can directly execute Python code. So if we, for example, type a statement like that, it will directly be evaluated and printed out. And we can also use that to import our file that we just created. So we are going to import the exercise 25 Python file like this. And now we can define a new variable called sentence. And here this is just going to be a string called all good things come to those who wait. So we define that sentence, and if we just type it in now, we can see that's indeed the value that's stored in it. And now we can go ahead and define a new variable words. We're going to use exercise 25, which we imported up here, and we're going to call break words, so the first function that we defined up here, actually on that. And we're going to pass in sentence, so the variable we defined up here. Let's press enter. Now we can type out words. And now, as you can see here, we have all basically the sentence we entered here, but it's now broken into individual words. So we're using the space character here, using the split function, split method, to separate actually the different words. So whenever we have a space in our original sentence here, This is going to be the separator to separate out those individual words. Now after that, we can define a new variable called sorted words. And here we're going to call sort words, and we're going to pass in words. So here, this list that we just defined of the individual words. So this is sorted words. And now let's take a look at the value of sorted words. And again, we called sort words. So this is the second function we defined, which should actually sort our words. So instead of being displayed in the original order, they should now be sorted. And we can indeed see that it's now sorted alphabetically. So we start with A, C, G, and so on and so forth. So it's sorted in the appropriate alphabetical order. Now let's continue. And next what we're going to do is, again, we're calling exercise 25. And we are going to type out print first word, which again is just the next function here. And we're going to pass in words as the input. And if you just take a look at that print first word, that's going to pop off the zeros word. So basically the very first entry in our words list here. Actually in this list here, words. And this is then going to be printed out. So therefore we see all as a first entry. In a similar way, we can call print last word and pass in words again. And this is going to return weight that is printed out, which is the last entry. And note that we're calling this function here and we're passing in words, not sorted words, and therefore it's a weight, the last entry in our list, and not who, because this one is a sorted one. All right, after that, let's call words again. And now we can see, since we called the pop function here, the pop method, we actually removed the first and the last entry from our list. So all and weight are now removed and they're no longer included in our words list here. Now after that, let's continue by using print first word. And now we're going to pass in sorted words. So instead of using words, which we used up here, we're now going to pass in sorted words, which again is sorted alphabetically. So here again, we're going to print out all, because of course it's the same first entry as words, because it was already in the correct alphabetical order. But if we now continue and we call print last word, and we pass in sorted words, we should now get a different output. Before, when we passed in words, we got weight back as the entry here. Now we should get who back, if that's working correctly. And here we say who is printed out. Let's take a look again at sorted words, and we should see that all and who are both removed. They're no longer displayed here because again we called pop on it, which is actually a destructive call, so it would actually remove those entries here. Next, we're gonna basically assign sorted words, or update the value for sorted word, by calling sort sentence and passing in sentence, which again was all good things come to those who wait. And now that should be sorted. If we take a look at sort sentence, we can see we are first using break words, which is the function up here that is actually splitting all the words based on their space character. So we would get this entry back here, as we have stored in words before. And then after that, we are actually going to return the sorted words. So it basically does two steps in one. So if we press on that, and that was typo. Let's see, return sort. Oh, there's actually a typo in here. What we have is sort words, and we may have to actually, we may have to re-import back exercise 25. And now if we may have to briefly import that again. So let's do that real quick. That's the reason why it's always important to check the spelling if that's correct. All right, so we imported that. Let's just briefly take the sentence here. And if we now take a look again at sorted words, what we're doing here is we are using exercise 25 sort sentence and we pass in the sentence and now we don't get an error anymore. Now if we take a look at sorted words, we can see here that we have the individual words printed out that we stored in sentence and they are already sorted. So we basically did two steps in once. We broke those words into, or the sentence into individual words, and then we sorted them alphabetically. Now let's continue and call print first and last and pass sentence to it. So this is our function here. So this should break our words and then print out both the first and the last word. So instead of using individual functions for that, which we did up here, we are now doing both at once. And we can see that both all and wait, so the first and the last word are printed out. And finally, we are going to call print first and last sorted and pass sentence to it. And now we are taking one additional step and we are basically also sorting the words here. So instead of printing out all and wait, what we did before, it should now return all and who, because we are sorting the words as well. And both of those are printed out. All right, so that's another option that we have available to us. If we don't want to execute the Python file directly, we can import it into our Python interpreter here and then run the different functions from there. And here again, we see the output that the author provides. So it's pretty much identical to what we saw. If you take a look at the last command here, for example, we see that all and who, both of those words are printed out. So as we go through each of these lines, should make sure that we find the function that's being run in our Python file up here, which we basically did when we took a look at that, and we should understand how it works. So that it's clear which functions are called. If, for example, one of those functions here at the bottom is actually using other functions to run, and so we can execute multiple steps at once. Let's now take a look at the study drills section. So first of all, let's take the remaining lines of what you should see, the output, and figure out what they are doing. Make sure that you understand how you are running your functions in exercise 25 module. So if you just revisit some of those outputs here, for example, at the bottom, let's just clear the screen real quick, and let's run, for example, the two last statements. First of all, we run print first and last, and we pass in the sentence. What happens here is that we take the sentence, let's just print that out real quick, this sentence here, which is the input, and we're taking the input as an argument here, the sentence, and then we call break words on it. So what happens here, if we scroll up to the top, we see that we pass in the sentence into break words, and then we call split on it. So we split the individual words, or the sentence rather, into individual words, and that's returned back using the return keyword here. Now once that's returned back, it's actually stored in words, and now we take this variable words and we pass it to print first word. And this function here would then actually take our words input, so these are all the separate individual words, and they are then, well, actually the first entry is popped off, which would be all in our case, and that is printed out. And we do the same for the last word here, so we print out actually the last word in our list. So that means if we execute this, we get back all and wait. So here the first entry, the first word all, and the last word wait. And building on top of that, we can see if we run print first and last sorted, we just have one additional step that we take. So here what we do before we actually call print first word and print last word, which of course is identical to the previous function, we first of all call sort sentence. And sort sentence also breaks the words into the sentence into individual words as we did here, but additionally it's sorting it. And therefore, since we are sorting it before we break it and then we sort it, the reason is then that we get back not all and wait, but we sort it alphabetically, so we get back all and who. And so we can use functions within other functions to really break down the functionalities and to reuse our code. Next, let's take a look at the next studied word section. Try doing this, help, exercise 25. And also help, exercise 25, break words. Notice how you get help for your module and how the help is those three quotation mark strings you put after each function in exercise 25. Those special strings are called documentation strings, and we'll be seeing more of them. All right, so that explains why we used those three quotation marks here at the very top of our function. So here, if we call help, and then we provide the name of the, in this case, of the file that we want to see, we can see the function names, and then just below, we can see the documentation strings. And since we called help on exercise 25, we can now see all the functions, so break words, sort words, print first word, and so on and so forth. They are all listed here. If we want to take a look at just one function, then we would type out exercise 25 and then the name of the function, separated after a dot. So if we do that, we only take a look at that one function. So in this case of, we take a look at break words. And again, we see, if we take a look at that, we can see the description below here. The documentation comment is displayed directly below that function. So that can be really helpful to take a look at the documentation and see that right away what a function does. So we have been executing our code file, and we always had to type out exercise 25 dot followed by the name of the function that we want to execute, and that of course can get quite annoying. And this is a shortcut so that we don't have to do that. In order to do that, we have to actually import everything. So we say from exercise 25, which is our Python file, import star or import asterisk, which basically stands for, this is a wildcard character, so that stands for importing everything from our exercise 25 Python file. So, and if we do that, we don't have to call exercise 25 dot the function name, but we can directly use the function name because we basically imported all of that ahead of time. So to do that, let's just go back into our Python interpreter here. And now instead of saying import exercise 25 as we did before, we are now going to say from exercise 25 import asterisk. And now if we just, for example, create a very short sentence, now if we do that, we can we should be able to simply call, for example, break words and then pass in sentence, and that should work instead of having to always type out exercise 25 dot as we did before. So let's take a look if that works, and it does indeed. So that's a handy trick if we want to import everything and we want to actually save having to type out the namespace, the name of the file that we execute in files from, then we would import everything from that particular file. All right, and finally, if we take a look at the fourth studied world section, try breaking your file and see what it looks like in Python when you use it. You will have to quit Python with Quitch to be able to reload it. We actually saw that by accident before. So if we, for example, just add a typo in here like this, and then we quit out of our Python interpreter and go back in here. And let's again say from exercise 25, import star. Let's define a short sentence here, like this. We can first of course call break words, for example, and pass in the sentence. That works properly, but if we now take a look at the function here where we entered a typo, so print last word, and we pass in sentence, for example, then we get an error here. In this case, it says name error, name words with 2s is not defined. And that happens, of course, because we defined a parameter here called words, and then we're using words with 2s inside here, so it's unclear. The function doesn't know what that actually is because we are having a typo in here. So we would actually have to correct that in order to run it properly. So finally, let's take a look at some common student questions. First one, I get none printed out for some of the functions. So in this case, you probably have a function that is missing the return at the end. So for example, we are missing this here. And what would happen here is that it basically returns none because the return keyword is missing, the return statement is missing. So to fix that, we should go back through the file and confirm that every line is right. I get bash import command not found when I type import exercise 25. Pay attention to what I'm doing in the what you should see section. I'm doing this in Python, not in the terminal. That means you first run the Python interpreter. So if we, instead of doing this inside of our Python interpreter, we actually run this up here in our terminal, then we actually end up with something unexpected because we run it in the Python interpreter and actually not in, excuse me, in the terminal and actually not in our Python interpreter. So we have to be really careful where we actually type in the commands. I get syntax error, invalid syntax when I run this. That means that you have something missing like parentheses or quotation marks or similar syntax error on that line or above. Anytime you get that error, start at the line it mentions and check that it's right, then go back backward checking each line above that. So that makes sense. If we get an invalid syntax error, then we probably made a mistake like this here, for example, that we added in two parentheses instead of one, or maybe we missed one. So that's really important to pay attention to. How can words.pop function change the words variable? So we saw that before when we call, for example, break words, or excuse me, rather print last word on our words list. We saw that if we called words afterwards, that for example here the last entry was missing. So that's a complicated question, but in this case words is a list, and because of that you can give it commands and it will retain the results of those commands. This is similar to how files and many other things worked when you were working with them. So in this case, if we call pop on something, that's actually destructive, so we can actually change our lists. So we have to be really careful. If we want to use it for later operations, then we should really make sure that we don't somehow change our lists and remove any values. When should I print instead of return in a function? So we saw here that, for example, at the very top, the first two functions actually return a value, while the next two actually print a value. So the return from a function gives the line of code that calls a function a result. So for instance, if we take a look at break words here, we can see that this function here returns words, so it returns a value, and since it does that, we can then pass that returned value to words, to a new variable, and then can use it. So for example, you can print it out. It wouldn't make any sense if we call print first words, which we see up here, that doesn't return a value, it just prints out a value. So it wouldn't make any sense to have a variable like this and say new word equals and then print, because actually print is not going to return anything. So that wouldn't be any useful output that we could use. So we really have to pay attention if we want to do any further computation with a value, then we should return it. You can think of a function as taking input through its arguments and returning output through return. The print is completely unrelated to this and only deals with printing output to the terminal. So print is should only be used if we actually want to print something to the terminal. If we want to do any computations, we want to actually return a value that we can work with further or do computations with, then we should always make sure to actually return that value. All right, and that's it for exercise 25. And see you guys next time in exercise 26.